everyone. So let's have a quick glance on today's newspaper headlines dated on 29 March 2019. So let us start from the front page of The Hindu. US circulates draft resolution on Azhar in Security Council. United Nations panel passes separate resolution on terror financing. The US on Thursday took the lead in bringing sanctions against Jaish-e-Mohammed Chief Masood Azhar at the United Nations by circulating a draft resolution among Security Council members. Now let us discuss about the sanction, that is 1267 Sanction Commission, which was failed to designate Azhar as a terrorist. So 1267 Sanction Committee, it is the United Nations Security Council who first imposed sanctions on Afghanistan in October 1999 with Resolution 1267 to force the Taliban, the de facto government of Afghanistan, and to hand over the terrorist Osama bin Laden to appropriate authorities. And Osama bin Laden had been indicated by the United States. Pehli baar ye sanction Afghanistan mein aaya tha, jo operate hua tha Taliban se. Aur terrorist Osama bin Laden ke liye, जिसको हैंड ओवर कर दिया गया था अप्रोप्रिएट अथॉरिटीज़ को, जो कि एक टेररिस्ट था. ऑन 30 जनवरी 2004 द सिक्योरिटी काउंसिल पास्ड रेजोल्यूशन 1526 टू स्ट्रेथन द रेजिम एंड डिमांडेड दैट ऑल कंट्रीज मस्ट बी इमीडिएटली फ्रीज ऑल इकोनॉमिक रिसोर्सेज फॉर द टेररिस्ट. 30 जन 2004 में सिक्योरिटी काउंसिल ने एक रेजोल्यूशन पास किया था जो 1526 रेजोल्यूशन था, और उस रेजोल्यूशन में ये था कि सारे कंट्रीज़ को इमीडिएटली इकोनॉमिक रिसोर्सेज फ्रीज कर देना चाहिए उन टेररिस्ट के लिए जिनका नाम लिस्ट में है, एंड प्रिवेंट एंट्री एंड ट्रांजिट थ्रू देयर टेरिटरीज ऑफ पीपल ऑन दी लिस्ट. तो ये है 1267 सैंक्शंस कमिटी जो कि फेल हो गई थी टू डेजिग्नेट अजहर एज ए टेररिस्ट, एंड दिस ऑल बिकॉज ऑफ द चाइना हु प्लेस्ड ए होल्ड ऑन a listing request that the US, the UK and France had brought before the committee. That listing request, the fourth such unsuccessful one in a decade, followed the February 14 suicide attack on a CRPF convoy in Pulwama in Jammu and Kashmir. In a related but separate development, the Security Council passed Resolution 2462 on terrorism financing. The resolution stresses the primary responsibility of member states in countering terrorist acts and reiterating their obligation to prevent and suppress the financing of terrorist acts, as well as its call upon all states to become party to the International Counter-Terrorism Conventions and Protocols as soon as possible. The US has bypassed the 1267 committee and filed the draft of the resolution to Security Council. This is not in line with the resolution of the issue through negotiations, Chinese Foreign Ministry spokesperson Geng Shuang said. Prime Minister didn't seek note for TV address Election Commission. Prime Minister did not seek the permission of Election Commission before going on air to announce the success of Mission Shakti anti-satellite missile test, which was held on Wednesday. At a press conference, Deputy Election Commissioner Sandeep Saxena said the Prime Minister office had neither informed nor sought any permission from the Election Commission for broadcast of his address. After the issue was raised, the Election Commission set up a committee to look into the matter. National security is Modi's pitch in UP. Talks of strikes on land, air and space. Making out a case, Prime Minister Narendra Modi speaking at a rally in Meerut on Thursday. Hitting back at Congress President Rahul Gandhi for mocking him with a Happy World Trade Day greeting, Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Thursday said he didn't know whether to cry or laugh at those intelligent people who confused anti-satellite with a set used in Twitter performances. Achievement ignored. Referring to the test at an election rally in Meerut, Mr. Modi accused opposition parties of ignoring the country's great achievement in space and said their reactions raised questions about their intelligence. Yesterday, when I spoke of anti-satellite, they got confused. They thought I was talking of a threat set, quipped Mr. Modi, questioning those who don't have any understanding of the difference between a threat set and a space anti-satellite missile. However, Mr. Modi did not name Gadkari terms Nyuntan I Yojana NYAY, a gimmick sites Congress record since 47. Union Minister questions source of funds for scheme. Nitin Gadkari. Speaking to the Hindu, Mr. Gadkari, renominated by the BJP from Nagpur, said the Congress's record in poverty alleviation did not lead to trust in terms of implementation of such programs. You just see from 1947, Prime Minister Nehruji assures the country that poverty will be alleviated than Indraji with 20-point program, etc., followed by Rajiv Ji with almost the same things, but as far as economic policies that could address poverty are concerned, the result for Garibi Hatao is zero. There is no credibility with regard to the Congress on this issue, he said. I felt that NYAY is a political gimmick. Where will you get the rupees 3,54,000 crore budget for that? That too over and above all the welfare schemes that the NDA government introduced. And by distributing this, where will you get the money to spend on roads, irrigation, schools and other infrastructure, he said. Punjab and Haryana High Court bars stating of caste in proceeding. Punjab and Haryana High Court has instructed Punjab, Haryana and Chandigarh not to mention the caste of the accused victims or witnesses in proceedings before the court. There is the details of the accused victims or witness, their name, age, caste and everything. So now Haryana and Punjab High Court instructed Punjab, Haryana and Chandigarh to not mention the caste of the accused. So caste will be not mentioned of the accused victims or witnesses. Four ecotourism centers closed in Wayanad. Environmental group files plea to stay activities off limit. The Kurua Island on the Kabani River in Wayanad district. Kerala High Court seeks response of official on heavy school bag. Petition seeks directive on reducing the weight of bags. Petition says carrying heavy school bags had an adverse impact on students' health. Artists from North East performing during the 4th Ethnic Cultural Meet in Guwahati on Thursday. So this is the 4th Ethnic Cultural Meet in Guwahati. NHRC 6 report from Odisha DGP on missing women, girls. The number of those missing had touched a figure of 11,000 till November 2015. Now, editorial news, power in space. So this article is based on the anti-satellite missile. Mission Shakti might have had one message for India and another for the world. India has entered an elite space club with the Defense Research and Development Organization DRDO blowing up a satellite in a low Earth orbit. India has become fourth nation after US, Russia, China that has capability to launch missiles to destroy satellite in low Earth orbit. India has been in the business of testing long-range missiles for years. Although public attention on the space program has been mostly on its civilian and scientific aspects, the military dimension, though always latent, had not seen a verifiable demonstration as in the case of Mission Shakti, the anti-satellite missile test. Although only three other countries, US, Russia and China, have previously demonstrated this capability, it is possible to surmise that countries with long-range missiles could do the same with equal effectiveness. But India surely is taking a forward claim as a space weapons power. While the country celebrates the test as a scientific achievement, it must also dwell on the possibility that this might could its non-too-friendly neighbor Pakistan into a competitive frenzy. Also, in the absence of a credible threat to India's space assets from China or any other country with anti-satellite missile capabilities, ideally, the test should not have been a matter for a partisan political debate, but given the hyper-nationalist political plank of the BJP, Mission Shakti might have more reverberations on the ground than it has had in space. The shape of an urban employment guarantee. Such a program will not only improve worker incomes but also have multiplier effects on the economy. India is in the midst of a massive jobs crisis. The unemployment rate has reached a 45-year high in 2017-18. As per leaked data from the Periodic Labor Force Survey report of the National Sample Survey Office (NSSO), according to PLFS, report, the unemployment problem is specially aggravated in India's cities and towns. Aside from unemployment, low wages and precarity continue to be widespread. Unemployment ke saath saath low wages bhi ek problem hai jo badhti ja rahi hai. In urban India, the majority of the population continues to work in the informal sector. Urban India mein jo majority hai population ki, wo informal sector mein jyada ho rahi hai. Informal sector jaise engineer hai, architecture hai, wo apne hi field mein jane ki jagah kisi aur field mein jate hain aur wo low field hoti hai jisme unko wages bhi bahut kam milte hain. Hence India cannot ignore the crisis of urban employment. An urban employment guarantee program not only improves incomes of workers but also has multiplier effects on the economy. It will boost local demand in small towns, improve public infrastructure and services, spur entrepreneurship, build skills of workers and create a shared sense of public goods. Hence the time is ripe for an employment guarantee for program in urban India. Now op news. Is Modi the best communicator of them all? Mr. Modi is a good communicator, but people want to see him speak on the issues that concern them. They want to hear how he addresses the issue of joblessness, the benefits of election deposit. In India, candidates who stand for parliamentary elections have to pay a deposit of ₹25,000. If the candidate is a member of a scheduled caste or a scheduled tribe, the amount is ₹12,500. For assembly elections, the amount is ₹10,000. For SC and ST candidate, it is ₹5,000. If the candidate is not elected and the valid votes polled by her do not exceed 1/6 of total number of valid votes polled by all the candidates, the deposit is forfeited. Agar candidate ko 1/6 se jyada vote nahi milta to jitna bhi number of votes polled honge सारे कैंडिडेट्स के तो वो उन्हें डिपॉजिट करने होंगे.